Hello and welcome back to more Monster Hunter Tri for the second part of the Baryoth fight. And I'm going to announce this now that I'm not going to do two fights for every single monster now on single player, because we'll see him again in multiplayer in high rank, which will be more dangerous and hilarious when I die. And possibly you could have other people from Game Anyone's commentary on it, because they might be joining me here. I just have to find other people that want to join me. Doesn't look like a lot of people on Game Anyone play Monster Hunter, which is why I'm playing it, so they can see, like, oh, this is awesome, I should go get it. Because it's, like, the one good game for the Wii. Besides, like, Super Mario Galaxy and Sonic Colors, maybe. And No More Heroes. No More Heroes is up there. I do have to say that. No More Heroes is up there. But no. Monster Hunter. Selling point. Definitely. Anyway, going to stupidly use the Troco gun. Tropeco gun, which is a folding frame for a medium bow gun to use fire. Because at this moment, you don't really have that great of bow guns to use fire. I mean, you can have decent ones, and you could have even more of a better one. That's a really long random phrase. You even have a better one if you would waste a whole bunch more time than I bothered with to get a Rathalos plate, because after fighting Rathalos around 15 to 20 times in one sitting, it was rather annoying to fight him some more. So I was just like, I have the tails that I need, I have all the other parts I would need if I get a Rathalos plate at some point, which I'm going to get one at some point, because I like that barrel. That barrel is good. I like that barrel. That's a nice barrel. Anyway, the Rathling gun barrel, I think is what it's called. You get fire shots, you get a shield, basically do everything that the heavy bow gun shield would do, except for I think it's a slight bit stronger. It's also lighter, so this might have been a light bow gun instead. I also may have not had to use a heavy frame or a folding frame, because we all know I hate folding frames. But anyway, the guild sweetheart has something for us to read, which you should have been reading, even though I've been telling you this, but main reason why I'm not doing both of them is, one, because I basically do one run that's going to be really good, because I use something that I'm good at, like, say, pellet shot versus one enemy, which also gets rather boring, and then a run that I do something different that ends up horribly failing, like this one. I'm not gonna use pellet shot on every one that comes up, because, yes, I know that's a little boring. I will do other ones, like the next boss, the Diablos. I use pellet shot, but I also use water shot, because they come up with this really cool Legiacrest armor, where Legiacrest unfortunately gets status attack down, but there's a but to this. It gets elemental attack up, it gets normal shot boost, which actually I don't use that many normal shots, because they still don't seem to do that much damage. Pellet shots in single player just seem to do so much more damage. In multiplayer, I'll use normal shots so much more than pellet shots, because, one, pellet shots could disrupt other people, and two, as a gunner, you're going to be aiming for the weak shots higher up, because that's your job. Your job is to hit with elements, and to hit higher up, and to put them asleep and do other statuses, but mostly the other two. Or not mostly the other two, but those other two as well, because you can reach them while everybody else can't. So you'll use a lot more normal shots, which in the Geocurse armor would be even better. So you have those three things, the normal boost, you get Olympic Swimmer, which means it's good if you're in the water, since this is the only game that's introduced water into it. And for some reason the Baryath doesn't want to come here. And it has enough slots in it. I think I might have mentioned this last episode, but it has enough slots in it to get attack up large, plus either having a charm that has two slots or a plus three or more attack charm, you can get attack up large with the Geocurse armor. And that's pretty sweet, I would have to say. So because it has a status attack has elemental attack up, I use water shots and some normal shots in there, but then I use pellet shots because I like pellet shots, and it makes dodging a lot easier when you're the only one there, and they do lots and lots of damage, which is why I tell you to use them. Anyway, with this one, I am using the Tropeco frame, the Wrathling gun stock, and the Heavy Bowgun barrel, which gives me some fire shots, which I use. Gives the standard bowgun things, like the heavy, light, and medium bowgun, all those give you some nice status shots, so I would take that into consideration. Nice status shots. And I was going to try to wait here until it came, but it's better to lure him here if you have a hunting horn. It works a lot better. But it didn't work. So I go to area 4, you know, just to look around. And he happens to be in there. So up with the gamma again. This part's not sped up. Trust me, other parts will be. Because this is the fail log with failing. If you all thought I was, like, super amazing at Monster Hunter, you are vastly mistaken. I am okay at Monster Hunter, at best. Marginal at Monster Hunter. I like playing the game. I think they're nice, challenging games, and I whiff a paintball there. And like I said before, Baryath. Total spaz. Total annoying. Luckily with the, you have a shield, and with the Wrathling stock, you have, like, little to no recoil. So, that's good. The armor that I'm using is the Baryoth armor. Blech. The Baryoth armor, which gives me attack up large, or it might just be medium. I might just have medium on it. It has attack up, either medium or large. I have Adrenaline plus 2, which I don't utilize because we're in single player. I mean, you can utilize it. As a gunner, you can utilize that the heck in multiplayer. Because the monster is not Baryoth always, and is not always going after you. If you can be not always targeted, Adrenaline's going to do bunches of damage. Let's see, okay, so Baryoth is poisoned. If you don't remember what poison looks like, it's when you have the little purple bubbles coming above its head. It means it's poisoned. Now, as you can see by the time bar, this is another long match, and it's because bowguns, for single player, they're kind of dropping off. The amount of frames and barrels and that you get to do attacks, or to increase your attack, is basically done. Let's see. You get... I don't think I die already, do I? No, I dive over to the other side. See, the next barrel, or next frame you get is... Thank you. Next frame you get is Ignactor's frame, which we don't know, we haven't seen Ignactor yet, but the music here just kind of illustrates the rest of this. Goes along with Baryov a lot, but, yeah, the next frame you get is Ignactor's, which, it's alright strong, I mean, it's about as strong as the poison sting frame. Poison sting? Remember the Gignox one? And explosion! I made sure the Giggies did not mess me up this time. I was mad about that. Oh no, Baryov woke up! Yeah, you have that, which it's a folding frame, which makes it really annoying. But if you're playing on, say, like online, it wouldn't be that bad. It's about as strong as the poison sting frame. It's not. You don't get that many good frames anymore. The stock, however, for Ignactor is awesome. Or at least for fire shots. You get 4 just from the stock. Which would be awesome against Baryov. But we can't fight him! Because we have to beat Baryov to fight Ignactor. Actually, we don't. But that's the arbitrary rules I put on myself. Fighting in the dark! See, isn't this fight like... Nah, this is why I only want to do these fights once! Or at least show you, because if we get to higher, or even multiplayer, they have more health, they do more damage, and you have more people coming around, and it's a lot more interesting. Also because there's a lot more epic dodges and whatnot. Or, not the... You don't have to continue to do epic dodging. Like, I know in the Diablos fight that I do awesome dodges. A lot. And again. And again. And again, and again, and again. It just keeps going. But you don't have to do that, like, you know, like 3 or 4 times in multiplayer. I know I keep talking about multiplayer, because we're going to get to it soon! Hopefully. We only have... Plus it cuts down from it being like 200 videos for this, to being only like 100 videos. Because we've got a whole bunch, I'm going to show off event quests, I'm going to show off a whole bunch of things, because there are lots of event quests. Like super small monsters, super big monsters, super awesome monsters. Elder Dragons, you know, the whole shebang. And this is just basically, he runs, I block, dodge, shoot. Run, dodge, shoot. Run, block, dodge, shoot. Run, block, dodge, shoot. I mean, there's nothing interesting with Baryov. It's just the same thing. I mean, it's not like you can be like, I'm going to be awesome, because I'm going to learn your pattern and do amazing against you. Because he's just so much of unpatterned. Besides the fact that he'll land, turn once, either jump or charge. But he's never going to jump now or charge now. He always does a round. So frustrating. You'll soon find out when I play this, or not when I play this, during this hunt, I go from flaming shots, which are doing okay. Excuse me. Excuse me. From flaming shots to pellet shots, because I don't have to take extra time to aim at the point when I'm already being targeted all the time. Are you going to play online with a gunner? You're going to want to make sure you have status attack, or at least be able to put on statuses, and then adrenaline is usually very good. There's another game which you can all play. You'd have to learn Japanese or or be willing to play, or have like a semi-translation guide. But the game's called Monster Hunter Frontier. Ginormous game, kind of like, well, it's basically an MMO. The most a Monster Hunter game could be an MMO. But you'd have to pay for it. It's a subscription, kind of like WoW or something like that. But let's see, where was I going with this? There, you can get so many gunner skills together in that game because the armor skills you have, like, you know how I'm like really happy when I get armor and it's got like +4 to attack or something like that. Oh, right, I fainted. They have parts where, armor parts where they have like +20. So that's like automatic attack up large. Kind of a fade here, cause Bowgun, come here! Oh no! And some more music just kind of to illustrate this. You're gonna get trapped, man. And hey, pellet shots! Because, although pellet shots plus critical eye minus is not the best, because each individual pellet can negatively crit, which means it'll basically go down overall in damage. So that's not very good. But otherwise, alright, decent. So like I was saying earlier, Bowguns start to fall off during this late part of the game, because yes, you can get the Wrathling Barrel, yes, you can almost always hit the element that the thing's weak to, but unlike, say, go with, that should have totally hit. I remember that. That should have totally hit. Say we're fighting, I don't know, Varia. Okay, we need a frame that shoots fire. Well, we can't get that until we get to Ignactor, which is a folding frame, which really is not that good unless you're gonna just do it as a heavy bowgun. So you better have a shield. Which you could do. You could have like the Kuropeko frame and the the Wrathling Gun stock and barrel, and then you'd have should have a heavy bowgun there, or at least it'd still act like a heavy bowgun, and you'd fire lots of fire shots, which could be decent. I should probably get that together, at least for a multiplayer. But your strongest frame hits 168 when it's maxed out. And it's not like the strongest short sword, which is basically what your damage could be comparable for, like a medium to light bowgun. You can get up to like 252, I think. You might be able to get up to 300. But unless you're having rapid fire, which we don't have rapid fire yet with fire shots, I don't think anywhere, the Wrathling short sword, you can do a lot more damage because you can get a lot more hits. And there we actually broke his claws, which is actually one of the subquests. Also, breaking one of his claws gets him angry. Just small bit angry, where he goes into rage mode. Oh yeah, some epic dodges. About time I had some of those. Go pellet shots. Epic dodging with pellet shots. Fly away, Barioth. We don't want you anyway. You don't have that yet. I mean, you could also do Thunder, but he's really short and doesn't stay still, so I wouldn't do Thunder. But you could Rapid Fire Thunder, but you don't have a Thunder don't have a Geocrest like barrel, so which could possibly be strong. Or you have a Geocrest barrel, you don't have a Geocrest frame, which could possibly be stronger, and therefore do more damage, or do more damage, because you know the barrel for it does a bit more damage. So logical explanation: frame would do more damage, but you don't have access to that. You get all of those in high rank. So bowgunning at the end point of the game here is kind of falling off, which is why these quests are taking a lot longer. I knew if I was much, much better at it, like, I would always hit... Man, I should have dodged that. Like, if I would always hit the weak point of Baryoth, which is his face, then I'd probably be able to do it a little bit faster, but you're not hitting that... Say, I'm using the hammer, which I love using the hammer on Baryoth. And by now, you could get the Blazing Red. Is that what it is called? I don't remember. Honestly, I don't remember. It's the... Oh, come on! I should have been blocked. It's the... Rathlos... Hammer. A hammer has an attack damage of 603, which, granted, with the amount of attacks that the short sword does to the amount of attack damage of the hammer, you do basically the same amount of damage. I don't know if everybody realizes that you have a scaling thing to it. A scaling thing to your damage that is based on what type of weapon class you're using. Or there's a modifier to it. Which the modifier for the bowgun is about the same as... It's a little bit less than the... short sword. So you have that. We're gonna let him fall asleep, and then we're gonna blow him up. Because I am tired of him. And if I was really cool, I would have blown him up with Wyvern Fire. To the face. I'm not. We're gonna go out with this with a bang, because it was kind of terrible. And I'll freely admit that this was kind of terrible. Try to get that other claw as well. You just don't have enough damage. Because the hammer, even though it's got a different modifier to it, you put yours up there too, Cha-Cha. Good, good. Couple shots to the shoulder, and he's down! You also don't have that many guns that have sleeping. In high rank, you have sleep shots in almost every gun, because the frames have it. Imagine that. Anyway, enough of me being like, I can't wait till high rank, but I can't wait till high rank, because we get some really cool weaponry. Or not even, I can't wait till high rank. I can't wait till multiplayer. But yes, this is the Baryoth fight. Tune in next time for one on Diablos, and then the next episode should be Urgon, and then the next one should be Ignactor, and then in a rematch with Rathlos, and then the final boss. I'm Zachary Chalcom. I've been your host for Monster Hunter Try. If you like what you see, or want to comment on my failure in this episode, leave a comment below, or hit that subscribe button up at the top of the page. Leave a rating for if you like what you see, or if you'd like to give some criticism on what I could do better, either in-game or video-wise, feel free to leave a comment on that, either on my profile or on this video as well. But anyway, I'm Zachary Chalcom, and I'll catch you guys later.